everyone, Harkins and Fett here from K&AGamers.
Hey-o.
Coming at you with impressions about the Battlefield 1 open beta.
Yes, Battlefield 1. Well, first off, the graphics suck. My gosh.
Frostbite.
Blocky. It's all blocky and the coloring's off. I mean, I can't believe this game has been out so long. When was this game released? This game was released...
It seems like years ago.
Game of the Year, and also got a Game of the Year. 2002. That's when it was.
That's right. Yeah, right alongside
Battlefield 1942. Right.
Yeah, that's right.
Battlefield 1, right?
Because they were all about the World Wars back then, so obviously they would come out with a World War One next to the other
Battlefield.
One.
Oh, I thought we were talking about Battlefield 1942.
Oh, okay.
Whoops. Okay, sorry guys. I thought that's what we were talking about. Yeah. No. Carry on.
But the beta itself. On the PC, as you've seen from our
I don't even know what to say about that one. Yep. Like, when I tried it on closed beta, guys, it was actually quite good. I had no real problems except for the fact that I kept crashing more than usual.
Mm-hmm.
You started off, because you got more gameplay in than me. I played it a little bit more. You played it more on PlayStation 4, correct?
Yeah, I mean, I played that thing like crazy.
I couldn't because Xbox Live.
Yeah, so you didn't really have any... You don't have that much experience except for the bad taste in our mouths that was in the PC.
The frame rate drop and everything. Hey, I did pretty well, though. I was doing pretty well.
That's true, and that footage of you putting the tank on top of the cannon was priceless.
Yes, that is amazing physics right there.
Yeah. But, yeah, it was pretty good on the console. The only thing I had to complain about was there was just one map, and there were two modes. And
yeah, I really thought that was really stupid, because all of the YouTubers we've seen had the Zeppelin, had, like, another map. And for us, they released only one, and it made no sense to me, because I'm like, why did they get to play on this map when we only got to play on the desert map?
I mean, they did get the Train of Doom, which is incredible.
It was cool, but I'd rather have seen the Zeppelin. The Zeppelin was where everything was at.
Yeah, I know. They were probably not prepared for an open beta with that kind of like resource.
They weren't even prepared
stuff.
For this.
Yeah, they weren't even prepared.
On the PC with Hark, we just had nothing but gun crashes, no guns, things, players just not able to shoot or play it.
But we get it, EA. You were hacked by someone who was angry at you, and we get it. Your servers couldn't handle it.
Solved fast enough was my biggest issue.
I found out that it was actually a resource problem with the server that didn't allow the guns to spawn in because it was being overloaded. But you know what? It was good on console, that's why I had to say, yeah.
Except, again, I'm going to say it again. I have played other betas, guys, and they have been much better. Seven Days to Die, for example. Early access beta. That thing was pretty darn good.
The first day of the beta on PC definitely had to be the worst experience I've ever had with some kind of early access game.
Now, off of that PC stuff, let's go over what we did like about the game. First off, I love the new destructible physics. I love the fact that the vehicles that... Like, if the enemy team is even, we get a sandstorm. If the enemy team is losing, they get the... Or if either team is low on tickets, I believe it is, or one team's winning over the other, they get the train. And the train or the Zeppelin, I like how they have altered the battlefield more than in Battlefield 4. In Battlefield 4, we play a lot of that. There was just no reason for the... destructible environment.
Yeah, the Levolution stuff was cool, but it never really gave you an advantage. It just changed the map.
Levolution never play a part in it because, you know, a lot of it had to be triggered by the player. And if the player didn't trigger it, it never happened. So it was basically pointless. It never changed anything up. I feel Battlefield 1 goes in the right step as adding in the Zeppelin and other things to really alter its... the battlefield itself, stuff to really change it.
Yeah. Which kind of goes into like how everything looks. Like, we only got one map, and you know, Austin was saying this, it looked like Tatooine, and obviously they used some of the same assets and stuff, but it worked so
well. And we'll go
well.
Into some things about what Battlefield 1 can teach Battlefront.
I think we've already explained that in our last commentary video. I think we're
But I'll say it one more time, guys. I feel that, like, I know there's a lot of people that love Battlefront. I know there's a lot of people that love the new Battlefront. I'm not a fan of it because there just isn't enough maps, there isn't enough game modes, and I don't feel like paying them $50 just to get a DLC pack when it should have been in the game. And I will also say that the destructible physics, the fact that they couldn't have capital cruisers crashing into the map, was total level evolution could have made Battlefront so much better. They took a safe zone, but they went too safe. I would have rather had them really push the game's boundaries, and I hope in number two they use evolution more, levolution more. You know what I mean? They need to involve destructible physics more. I think it will really change the game a big bunch and make it more fun.
Yeah, but going into the main gameplay of the actual beta, it was pretty solid. Like, there's some balance issues, glitches, but the only kind of complaint I have besides OP stuff is the platforming. There would be moments where I would try to climb up to where another enemy player was.
They just wouldn't let you climb.
It would be like you would just push back off again.
Like, this is a cool feature to add, Battlefield. It's a great feature. It wasn't in Battlefield 1. This new feature grants us new mobility, new ways to get into new locations. But the fact that we don't have that, I don't like it. I don't like that idea.
Yeah, I mean, for walls and stuff, it works pretty cool how you can climb up, but on uneven terrain, like, they just did not code the terrain well with it, so hopefully they'll improve that. But
that was the only problem I saw with movable physics. Bouncing off your body, that needs to be
fixed. Oh, yeah, that's definitely a beta thing.
They have a problem too in Battlefront with the Stormtroopers' cloaks for the Snowtroopers.
Oh yeah, I remember that. How they'd go crazy. Something with the physics.
If they can fix that, I think the game would look pretty good.
Oh yeah, that's definitely just a beta thing.
The classes are nice. It's just players need to learn to use them right. I found a lot of people who would play as assault need to learn their role. They can't just only assault. They also need to be used against the tanks.
Oh yeah, definitely.
I also didn't like the fact that there wasn't enough, like, I want to see what else other gear we'll get, but I didn't feel there was nothing to fight the air and vehicles with, because once you lost the mounted turrets, like, for anti-air and stuff, you just kind of felt like, you know, what's useful against them.
Well, from the footages you've seen, people, you've seen that tanks are pretty good against airplanes, because they're so slow, so it's like a lot of stuff, even the sniper comes with high caliber bullets, anti-tank bullets that you can load. And so those are probably really good against
planes.
One thing
I'm seeing come over from Battlefield 4, even in other Battlefield games, to Battlefield 1, is the fact that each class and each vehicle plays a specific role in this game. And I think I like that the most about it.
Yeah.
The tanks are hefty, but if you don't give them infantry support and people use their assault, they're easily taken out.
Oh, yeah.
They'd be easily taken out, so you need infantry support. Even though I do think the tanks are a little bit too OP because you can't disable them fast enough, and they take a hell of a lot of hits before they're destroyed, so you kind of got to either use your tanks or everybody has to go Rambo with grenades and just spam.
Well, it's kind of depending on your class of tank, getting into the different classes of vehicles. The heavy tank definitely takes a lot of hits. You know, my favorite for a while was the little Renault, which in the game is like the FT-25 or something. I don't remember.
You mean the Caterpillar?
The little light tank with the turret.
Oh, yes. No, I know what you're talking about, the little Russian.
That one is pretty nice.
I didn't
even
have that one.
Oh, it's really good, but the thing is it doesn't do that much damage to things like the heavy tank.
Yeah. But then, like, you got the other heavy tanks. What's it called? The Caterpillar?
The Land Crawler is definitely a teamwork vehicle.
It's a tank where you can't just get in it and drive it like crazy and think you're going to go Rambo. You do need to take precautions against other tanks. This is the same Battlefield, except I feel like in Battlefield 4, rockets actually, like, there were rockets. Rockets were a threat. Mm-hmm. Now we don't have rockets. So what's the next best thing? Well, we got the grenades, but we also have the tanks. So your tanks are going to play a big role in this. Tanks are definitely playing this. Again, tanks are playing a very big role. I noticed a lot. If you lost your tank, you are pretty much screwed.
Yeah.
You can't lose your tank. So players have to definitely, when they're driving the tanks, know, okay, I can't go Rambo with these tanks like in Battlefield 4. I have to make sure I keep my distance and, you know, use them effectively.
It's funny because probably right now I'll be showing footage of me going Rambo in my tank, killing everyone.
Yeah, but if you have a good team in there.
Exactly. That goes right back to people knowing how to use their assault classes.
Battlefield, take a lesson, because that's another thing.
Yep. But the vehicles on the land were pretty good, but the air, you had your fighter bomber, which fires...
I liked how air combat was. Like, the fact that, you know, it could definitely affect the battlefield, but it wasn't so much as, you know, like, you guys have seen in other battlefields, like Battlefield 4, planes and aircraft have always been a pain because they could jet ram, they could really devastate you on the battlefield. These planes are so basic now, they're actually not too much of a threat. They can still be a threat, but they're, you know, they're up in the air, you can see them, and they can play a key role as well.
Oh yeah, they play their roles well, because when you're in a fighter, you're too fast to shoot at the ground, but you're fast enough and maneuverable enough that you want to take out the fighters. The bombers are slow, but those bombs are devastating and can take out tanks really easily. So they play their roles really well in the air.
If you're a good pilot, you can definitely devastate Battlefield with that.
Way better than what Battlefield has even done in the past with jets and choppers.
Yeah. Jets were just... I didn't like the way jets were taken because they were just very annoying. And
they were very basic, weren't they? They were just like, oh, you lock on, you fire. Oh, someone's locked on, you pop flares, and that's it.
And you bail out and you become... Actually, let's go on about that. I'm going to go off on this with the idea of bailing out. I like the idea that now, instead of having just basic classes of engineers, we actually get it when you jump out of the plane, you're a pilot. When you jump out of the tank, you're a tank crewman.
Yeah.
And you have a key loadout. So, in other words, you don't want to surrender your tank, but if you have to, you better find another tank. You are still not meant for combat.
Yeah, even though the pilot and the tank crewman... pistol is pretty awesome, I have to admit.
But you're still, your role, you can repair vehicles on the outside, so you're still playing a key role. You still play that really key role, you just gotta be more careful now. Same as with the horseman. And we're gonna go on the horseman, because I think OP as hell. The sword is, they need to fix the sword, because the sword is not melee, like, fixable. That thing is way too, it's got too much of a range.
Like, forget about the horse. Let's just talk about the actual, like, cavalryman himself.
Yeah. Horses are interesting. I wish there was a death animation, but they were...
There is, actually.
There is. I never saw it. I never got to see it.
Yeah, there is. They're just really tough. But the thing is about the horsemen...
Which is weird.
I just... Sometimes I don't even get on the horse. I just get off and fight with the rifle.
That's
because there's so much freaking health. I played with several friends... on the console, and we were all in a party, and we would do like a private match, kind of. There was only three of us in the server, and the guy would just come up behind me and shoot me in the back, and I'd go down maybe a quarter health. I'd turn around, bam, bam, he's dead. And it's like, then I regenerate again, and then I have all these things like deploy ammo, deploy health, throw grenades. All this freaking stuff I have is a horseman, and then he has a good gun and like a huge amount of health. So it's like, out of all the vehicles, the horseman is the most OP vehicle.
Yeah, he is. He really is.
So that, I think they'll fix that. That's definitely only a beta problem.
Something needs to be fixed. Snipers seem to be the biggest key unit in this game because, again, the maps are very open.
Yeah.
They're very wide. Like, there are nothing on the islands. I've seen no island maps, or I don't think there is any island maps in World War One. To tell you the truth.
Sniping may actually be easier in this game because there's actually less bullet drop.
Yeah, and the things I think makes sniping easy in this one is, one, there's very little foliage. You have very few cities, except for a few maps, but it's not in the cities anymore. So you have wide open area to literally snipe anyone if you're good enough and you're watching your scope.
The big balancing problem that counters the snipers is the scopes. the scopes blare out so much, unlike in Battlefield.
You gotta be really good and quick, and if somebody is watching, they will catch you. They will catch you really quickly.
So maybe a tip here is, I don't remember.
Don't zoom in as much.
So does it only shine when it's zoomed in, or do you have to change your rifle?
I think it does.
Okay.
Because I don't see why it would shine even if you were ever. Just imagine if it shined even when you had the gun when you were running. That would be weird. I think it's only when you're zooming down your sight, guys. It'll glow. And they had this in Battlefield 4 as well, I've noticed. You at times see a flicker from a sniper.
But in that game, there's very bright, vivid colors that kind of make it blend in.
Yeah, I like the way the Battlefield 1 goes in its graphics, because talking about graphics, Battlefield 4, I always thought it was a little bit foggy to me. It never looked right. It always looked very bright. I agree with Hart. Always looked bright. Always looked kind of like there was a fuzz over my screen. Then you go over to Battlefield 1, and it just looks nicer. It doesn't look like there's much of a film grain over it. It's just beautiful looking. It's nice looking, and it looks nice. There's nothing too much extra to it.
Yeah.
Which I like. I don't mind that. I really don't. And I thought that sand looked very nice. They got the sand down perfectly.
Yeah, with the rushing wind and
sand. And I love when the scenery would change to a storm. I loved it because it altered your playstyle immediately. That stuff really alters your playstyle. Because it's like, okay, now we got a kicking up sandstorm. You can't see in front of you. Snipers are having trouble now.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to not be able to see as many people long range, so you have to have people spot for you.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how it would have affected the planes. I never even thought about that.
I spawned on a plane, and I was in the back gunner seat, and it was sandstorm, so I was like, how does this guy even know where he's going? And because I look in front, and it's like he could not see in front of him at all. But the thing is when he would rise up, you could actually kind of see above it. So you would have to, like, go over the sandstorm.
Okay.
Which is kind of cool.
Let me think. Well, let's think about the game mode. We played primarily, probably the most, was Conquest.
Yeah. And Rush was pretty good, too, though.
Which one? Rush?
Yeah, Rush fit its role.
Yeah, it fits pretty well with it, I think. The map suddenly fit Rush very well. They fit. Actually, I think the maps fit both modes really well.
Yeah, they do.
Which is very nice. I'd say Rush. I think Conquest though is my favorite, only because again, multiple points, multiple area to get headshots on. You're not staying in one position.
Yeah.
I do like how they did the vehicle thing, and again, Battlefront, take a note. Mm-hmm. I like the fact that it was, rather than just a tank sitting there, you had to be the first to click on that point, and then you could select what vehicle you wanted.
Yeah.
It wasn't just like, you know, randomly. So you could actually have two of those crawlers, right? You could have two of the Caterpillar tanks, or the, what are they called? What did you say they were called? Land Raiders?
Yeah, the Land Crawlers.
Yeah, Land Crawlers. You could have two of them, right? Could you have two of them? Or was it like, if you had one, you had to pick a different tank?
I have no idea, but just right there at the spawn menu, you can just choose your vehicle type, and it was really cool, and, you know, they all fit their roles really well. Even the light vehicles, like the Jeep, the armored Jeep with the turret, and even the, the anti-air truck?
Yeah.
Like, those all were really good, and I really liked all of them.
Again, you got to utilize each one, in my opinion, to the best of their abilities.
Yeah.
To really use them to their full purpose. So, and again, this goes for all Battlefield games. Battlefield has done this very well in both. And for many people, I know for me, it pisses me off sometimes when I go to play Battlefield, especially Battlefield 1 and other ones, when you go in there solo and you're just instantly dying. You're constantly dying and you don't know why. Well, it's because it's always been a team player game. It's always teams. It's been like, you know, you have to have the medic. You can auto-heal, but you still got to have the stupid medic. You got to have the medic there. You got to have the engineer. You got to have the LMG guy to suppress them. You know, each role keeps playing out. I've never noticed that until now, but it does, each part does play very well into the game.
Yeah, that also reminds me, as a medic, you know how you can revive people?
Yes.
There's no markers. There's no markers for people that get down. And there's a thing where you can notify people or medics
yes,
near you.
Yes, I know what you're talking about, yeah.
And it's never worked. I've never had someone revive me.
And because nobody gives a crap.
There's no UI for it. There's just no interface for it, and they definitely need to put that
yeah,
in.
Yeah, I would insert that. I mean, there's realistic guys, and then there's, you know, you can't, with this kind of game, with how fast-paced it is.
Yeah.
And maybe it's not too much fast-paced, but you got to think, like, if you're ever playing Battlefield 4, it can be very fast-paced. Same as Battlefield 1.
Speaking of fast-paced, you also can't spawn on people while they're under fire. Remember me talking about that in Battlefront?
Yes.
Saying how we need something that stops you?
I've done that in Battlefront, but I know in Battlefield they've always done it right, and it's always really nice because, you know, if you are under fire or you are somewhere else, it does help.
Yeah. So you don't spawn into, like, a hellfire anymore, and people would always be like, well, just be careful when you spawn. Well, now it actually... it stops you so that you just don't give kills to the enemy.
Yeah, definitely. I would definitely say that is another one.
Melee is another thing that I wanted to
Melee's
talk about.
Nice. I do like melee.
I mean, the only things we've really had were the sword on the horse, we had the club, and we have the shovel. But I feel it almost feels similar to Battlefield 3, where you knife someone and it does half damage if you don't kill them. And then it goes into, like, a takedown mode. That's what it feels like, except it just looks better.
Yeah.
But it's still pretty cool how they do it.
Doesn't it, like, also stagger them? Because I would get a lot of kills, actually, I think a lot of kills instantly, because I think I was doing, like, assassinations. I will say, like, the assassinations are much more fluid. So
yeah,
like
when they're down on the ground, you hit them and kick them and stuff, and it's pretty cool.
It's very much more fluid. It's not as, like, you know, you stand there and you are slowly assassinating them. It's much more fluid. It's boom, you're dead, he pushes them away, he keeps going.
Yeah, and obviously they'll probably do more cosmetic improvements with that once it gets out beta.
There is the charge melee, but I didn't use it as much as I thought I would. A lot of people were using it to kind of speed up. There is a delay if you do use
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you can't sprint then.
But I didn't really see a purpose to it too much.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. There's footage probably playing right now showing me stabbing a heavy guy. You know, the machine gunner with the armor plating and stuff?
Yes.
You can still one-shot him with a bayonet charge. So there's a purpose for it.
Going over that, let's go over the special weapons.
Yeah.
There was only a few in this game for the beta. I think those are all that will be in there. It's different from Battlefield 4 because before it was just a random weapon you found. Now it's actual gear. You become a specific unit. So there's the flamethrower.
Mm-hmm.
There's the heavy-duty LMG guy, which I will classify as heavy from TF2.
Yep.
World War I heavy. And the sniper. Or the... I believe that's a tank buster scope. Sniper rifle. I think it's a tank buster sniper.
Probably.
Because those rounds definitely, to me, sounded more high intense. I only got it once, but I never got to use it.
There were some things, like, I thought at first that using the high caliber bullets guarantees you a one-shot kill, and I thought, well, that's kind of overpowered for a sniper. But I did it the other day, and it only did 80 damage. It didn't one-shot them.
I don't know how those work. Those high caliber, are they for tanks or are they just for...
They're for tanks, but the thing is that I think they have a little bit more bullet drop because they're heavier, so it's kind of harder to snipe infantry with them.
And I'm also going to recommend not using those against the tanks. I mean, unless you got a side shot or a rear shot.
It's pretty good because, I mean, if you have nothing else and you're pretty far away from them, that's pretty effective if you just
start
doing
damage. That's why the snipers
have
them. Yeah. And then the LMG guy, what is he really good at?
LMG actually gets claymore, or what are they called? They're kind of like
bouncing betties.
Yeah. Where they do the strap things, though, like the claymores, where they strap against walls. And that's kind of interesting that the support class gets that, you know?
Probably for camping, because, I mean, personally, I don't mind them having this. I think they had them back in the Battlefield 4 also. But I don't mind them having that because, again, as an LMG guy, you're not going to be running around with your LMG unless you're Battlefield 4.
It's actually kind of ineffective to run around with it because it's really
inaccurate.
You're
going to be that guy who supports fire.
Yeah.
Rather than just spraying and praying, you're going to be holding back, keeping the enemy pinned because of your massive clip so your assault guys can get in close. That's basically it.
And another thing is that, like, even though it's inaccurate and stuff, if you lay down, if you have a bipod, it automatically clips to the bipod. So, which is really cool.
There's no more aiming at the sight, so that's nice.
Yeah.
Let's see. Flamethrower, again, cool weapon. It is very ineffective, though, if you don't have a team.
Inside, it is extremely effective.
It's scary. It's very scary.
Yeah, fear factor.
But I actually, no. I have to say, what is it called? Rising Sun, correct? Rising Storm. I think it was Rising Storm, that game made by Tripwire.
Oh, Red Orchestra?
Yeah, Red Orchestra, the American one. That one was the most scariest thing that I've ever
seen. Oh, yeah, of course.
Like, seeing that thing blow through a window, you just see this guy run out burning. Like, that got to get back to that.
Definitely.
I can definitely see those flamethrowers good against tanks, but again, they need to be, you need to use them as a team. Because if you don't use your medic as a team, the guy's going to die instantly, and that's the other
one. One thing I'm kind of disappointed in is because when you're in a tank in first person, your view is pretty limited. You could barely see anything, but the thing is that you could go third person, and you could see all around you, so it kind of gets rid of the, that's kind of a balance factor that they need to address.
What I always got a problem with that was the fact, like, even in Battlefield 4, they have it, and the problem I have is if you're trying to sneak a landmine on them or something, they're going to see it and they get out of the tank.
Yeah, which is a good opportunity for you to get in the tank, and I've seen people do that all the time. So you just hop out, and, you know, once you hop out, the person's going to get right in, and then you're kind of screwed.
No, I think that's in the first one, in the new one as well, but... Don't verify me on that.
Yeah. But another thing I wanted to talk about is, since the maps, obviously, for, like, Conquest are going to revolve around teams getting some kind of advantage, like the Zeppelin or the train, I'd like to say that the train is kind of powerful, but at the same time, there's footage of me in the tank holding back and actually getting kills and doing severe damage to the tank. Or the train.
Yeah, I'm going to say, like, those game changers, they're awesome, but yet, you know, again, the Zeppelin, you can fly it around the entire battlefield, but it doesn't have, like, ultra cannon.
Another thing I like to say is it depends on who's driving, because whoever drives that train to the edge of the map, there's nothing out there. What are you going to do? So it's, like, it's very important you get a good driver in there to get that thing to where you need the fighting.
Basically, guys, when you get that thing, don't even hold back. Just unload like crazy with it.
It can take because the hits.
Yeah, I mean, just unload. There's no point to not unloading. I mean, if you're losing that bad, unload it. I do wish they would use it more like I found, like, when the team was literally almost about to lose, mm-hmm. then the train would show up. They need to limit that. I'd rather have the train show up maybe, like, midway on a timer, like, one, like, at a certain point in time. Then the train shows up, not right before the enemy team loses. More like, you know, if the enemy team is holding out and they're down by, like, so many points, maybe 2 points or, I don't know, 20, the train's got to show up at this top.
Mm-hmm.
And then whatever team has lowest points wins. And then the big question is, our teammates, are they going to push for, like, you know, well, let's lose a little bit of points so we get the train? I don't think so. I think players are still going to try to rush to beat the game in quickest time.
I mean, there will be a lot of people who just won't notice. Like, I never notice what causes the train to come in.
Yeah.
So it's like there's going to be all those people that just won't know, won't be paying attention to that. Mm-hmm. But another cool thing about things like the Zeppelin, the train, is the parts get damaged. I've disabled some turrets with the tank, and actually they can't shoot me with those turrets because I've damaged them. And... the tanks, like the light tank with the turret cap, I've shot the turret and it says turret jam, and it actually jams their turret, and they can't turn it.
That's always great. That's always great. Now, see, now I wonder with the snipers, is that going to be their goal, where they can disable tanks?
And the same thing with fighters, too. Like, I've had it where my wing gets chopped up, and then it pulls that way.
I didn't see this in game. I didn't get to experience that in the game for the beta. but that's a big key right
there. Yeah, module damage.
And I would have loved to have that in Battlefield 4, mainly because tanks were deadly on Battlefield 4 as well. And to have them maybe like have a track disabled or something, it would teach players, okay, you can't rush into tanks.
Yeah.
So now this is going to be, again, tanks are heavy, but they're going to have to be treated more as the AT-ATs or the AT-ATs in this game. They need to be protected.
Yeah, I mean, there's also, like, most of the footage there of me in the tank is like, I slaughter about 30 guys until that one guy comes along who knows how to use his grenades, and then he disables me and I can't kill him, and then he blows me up. So it only takes one guy that knows what he's doing to take out a tank.
Exactly.
But yeah, what, you got anything else you want to add? I mean, that pretty much covers everything.
Besides from the fact that Battlefront needs to get its act together.
Besides from the fact that we want... This is a legit Battlefront now, EA, DICE, so, or Battlefield. So don't do the Battlefront thing and give us, like, 6 maps.
I'm just saying, like, I don't like... Like, I shouldn't be criticizing them as much as I do, but they literally have it in the palm of their hands. Battlefront could literally take this game and probably make it into Battlefield. They could take this Battlefield game and make it Battlefront with so much ease. Because it is so well made,
yeah.
I think. Like, in my personal opinion, guys, after playing the game, I think it's very well made. I like how the tanks just don't spawn there. You have to either die or respawn to get in them. The planes are the same way. The horses are somewhat the same way. The only thing different is the jeeps, which if you replace them with speeder bikes or land speeders, no real difference.
I mean, it makes the battle feel very smooth because it's not like, oh, this tank just comes out of nowhere. It makes it feel like it's come in from someplace. See it come in.
It's not like, you know, you're splitting at the enemy's base, the tank spawns and you can steal it.
Yeah.
So now you actually have to have, and if I'm not mistaken, most of the tanks also spawn not at points, but spawn at your main hub. So
there are actually on the map in Conquest, when you take a particular point, you could spawn a tank on there. So it's kind of like that gives you some,
It gives you a reason to go get that point.
Yeah, exactly.
If you start remembering where those key points are, like with the flamethrower and everything, those are key points to hold.
Yeah.
Because you know you can get better reinforcements from them. Again, this is something I also thought Battlefield could use, where it's maybe like landing in troops. If you control this point, you can aerial troop, you can get aerial bombardments or something from it. You know, some reward comes from it. Bombardments, you get those. And Battlefield did this before in Battlefield 4 with the commanders. Hit this point, and I can call an AC-130, you know?
Yeah, there was... one thing we haven't actually covered is single player. How I feel the single player is going to is, you know how the multiplayer is all about running around and all that? You're going to have that in single player, but I feel like they're going to try and do some traditional levels.
They're
going to
have the trenches.
Yeah.
And from what it's looking like, it's going to be what Battlefield 4 was, where you have a special operations team of a certain amount of people, and they're undercover, and they're trying to uncover what the Germans are doing.
Yeah.
The Germans have some super weapon, and it's probably the Zeppelin or something, and we have to fight them. So there's going to be a battle raging around you while you're moving through the trenches, trying to get the key areas. I also hope they use the nerve gas more, because I didn't see it enough in the game.
I know, there would be points where I would actually use that gas to my advantage.
Yeah, but it was so sad because it was only in grenade form.
Yeah.
And you might as well make the nuke in grenade form. Because I'd want to see bombardments. Like, if you take a point, you can call in a bombardment of gas. And then you have to use the mask. I want the mask used more. I want to see it come into play.
Yeah, in the rush game mode, when you would lose your 2 points... And then it would be like the voiceover would be like, okay, retreat. We have artillery that will hold them back while you retreat. And, you know, you look at their lines and it would be like, poof. And that would be it. So it's like, I really hope they add in like actual, like the entire edge of where they can go is just being bombarded to death.
I'm just thinking of Star Wars. Like, imagine if that's all it was. Poof. Just one laser beam from the Star Destroyer.
I mean, it was literally just a line of small explosions. It was obviously placeholder, but, you know, I hope they do something really cool.
For a second, I thought you were going to say, like, oh, no, they used the gas there. And I was going to be so amazed because I never saw that. All I ever... I remember once I looked and I'm like, okay, wait. And I looked up and I never saw the bombs come. I never saw them explode. I'm just like... And then they're like, move forward. It's like, what the hell am I waiting for? Like, have they bombed us yet? Are they coming down?
Another thing I want to add, though, the gas mask. Pretty cool. There's some glitches where, like, it doesn't act like you put it on.
Yeah, I've had that happen.
But the thing is that you can't aim down your sight when you have the gas mask on, so it's kind of a vulnerability putting it on. But it's really cool if you, like, have a bunch of people throw the gas grenades, and then you all put on the mask going for a point. That'd be really cool close quarters.
I can definitely see it being used a lot for clearing out buildings.
Yeah.
Like, using the gas for buildings more than the grenades, because the grenades are just going to blow up everything, so you're better off just going with the gas, because, you know, somebody's got to put on a mask, and it's going to take them time to get the mask on.
Yeah.
So, it depends on you guys, how you like to play, if that's the kind of Battlefield you like. I know I'm more of a fan of World War II. I am still a fan of World War II, and I'm slowly getting into Battlefield 4 again because, you know, it's not a bad game.
It's not bad. It's entertaining, you know, and, you know, they've obviously improved it. EA is having this bad habit of releasing a game that isn't done or doesn't feel well, and then they improve it afterwards, and they need to kind of cut that out.
But we'll see what happens, because Battlefield 1 definitely seems like it's going to be
good. Yeah. Then again, we said that about Battlefront, didn't we? Because that map, the Hoth map, everything, that felt really good. Yeah. But that was kind of all we really got.
But I think we really should have looked at how the vehicles were being used and everything, because everybody should have... Because I think everybody should have known those whole pickups were a bullshit idea, and I hate it to this day, because they're just stupid. I go out there and have to go find them, then And the stupid scrimmage mode is so broken, so stupid. Yep. There's no point in the stupid scrimmage mode. Because all the NPCs use shield bubbles. Why do they all have shield bubbles and I don't?
I know.
I have to use an effing jetpack and they all get shield bubbles so they can take more hits. It's stupid. It's so freaking stupid. They don't even let me use my gear.
Yeah.
I could literally go out and buy a better game. I'm sorry. But that's my opinion. I don't even play the Battlefront game anymore. Maybe I'll get the Death Star DLC. I like where it's going, but I didn't even get my Chewbacca in the first game.
I know.
And the first time it came out, they didn't give me Chewbacca or Obi-Wan. I wanted my Chewbacca. Chewbacca was my favorite character in the Star Wars series. And Han Solo. Where's my Chewbacca? Where's my R2-D2? They say we're going to be able to play as R2-D2 now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's the new hero. You have escort him out, so some player has to play as him. How many people do you think are going to F us over with that?
He's going to be like tasing his own guys.
Yes.
That'd be funny.
All right, guys. Well, that's it for the I was about to say live stream, but the review. Leave a comment, again, on what you think it is, whether you're interested in this game or not. I'm interested. I think this is going to be a good Battlefield. I can't wait to see them take this, and if they do come up with another Battlefield 2143, which is a futuristic one with walking tanks, I would love to see them take this gameplay and put it into that, because I can definitely see Titan vehicles flying in the air, and it just, they can definitely go futuristic with this now, because they definitely have the ideas of futuristic, and just having the ability to spawn in vehicles at the spawn point, just, it makes sense. It fits the game purpose well, and it makes it so much more smooth.
Yeah.
Gameplay feels much smoother, doesn't feel as fast-paced, feels much nicer.
Mm-hmm.
So, take it or leave it, that's our opinion.
Yep.
Yeah.
And we hope you enjoyed the footage and everything. You know, take our opinions with a grain of salt. But that's what
we
have to say.
Don't pre-order.
That's right. Don't pre-order. Not yet.
Because we all pre-ordered Battlefront. Well, I didn't, but, you know, some of us did. And God help us. I still don't know why people still support the game, let alone still play it. I have more fun playing Battlefront 2.
So, wait. Make EA a little nervous, you know. Make them want to please
don't
us.
Don't pre-order. Like, trust me, I tried the 1911 when I tried the beta. It wasn't much good. And, you know, I'm going to tell you right now, if you pre-order and get a new gun, you're probably going to throw it away after the first round because you'll find something better. That's usually how it goes.
I mean, let's hope it isn't like the freaking Han Solo blaster thing, where it's like you get
if they that. Do that, if they, you know, because they're going to do it, they're going to do that. You know, you buy and you get all the guns free and stuff.
I know, they'll do those packs and stuff, but you know, whatever.
But again, this is going to be, you know, this game's going to be one of those. You know, it's going to be a while before that. I know they did it for Battlefront. You can buy all the starter pack cards and guns.
Yeah,
and,
but hey, you know, they're allowed to make money as long as they make a good product, you know.
As long as they make a good product, but I still don't like it because, you know, you can at least work up to it.
Yeah, so hopefully it'll be worth it in the end.
And it doesn't even matter. All right, guys, see you all next video.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye.
I just want everybody to know, I looked up how to date, and it says, let your friends set you up. My friend doesn't have...
I'm pretty good at setting Austin up, but it's usually for death.